It's a very interesting question. It's a very long response.
And what made you decide to publish a book, and what do you want to say?
It's a story about a friendship, first about Julien Classens and me. And he did amazing photographies of my work backstage. We decided to make this project like that, naturally. He had the feeling to do that it was good to do a book, and when I saw the pictures, I just said, yeah, let's do it, it's so beautiful. This is like a backstage situation, like we all know it. She's just a girl, it's like a ghost. And here's like everybody is crazy.
The magazines you created, they are showing your work in different perspective. Do you think it is important to present your aesthetic through different kinds of medium?
It's good sometimes to accept to do a special project, to do something different. I personally love photography, I love colors, I love drawings, paintings. I can find, you know, a lot of possibilities to show creative things, personal things. But if I had time, I would do more, you know, all the potentials that you have inside, you have sometimes to take a bit of time to work them.
I think you're one of uncompromising designer. I feel kind of skeptical about conventional fashion system like a seasonal fashion show and the unified form of catwalk. There are things I wish to explore more, but it seems difficult to find the balance between fashion as a business and creative work in a more pure sense.
A lot of people in my family have like a background that is very concrete, or engineers, or you know, people working in banks and these things. And in the same time, you have amazing business people that are attracted in fashion because they understand style and they have a sensibility. Much more interesting is the incredible alchemy that can exist when people met and they can make a whole bursting fire. But you should always go into projects where you share a common interest. The inspiration has to be quite strong and pure because it's going in the right direction. And it's always a work you have to share with other people. You're never the only one that takes the whole thing on your shoulder, the whole responsibility. It doesn't exist.
I kind of struggle having to show a new collection every 6 months. We have already more clothes than we need.
To create a lot of things is not probably a bad thing, but what survives is also a natural way. If there are 1,000 designers making like 70,000 clothes, there will of course be a selection, a natural selection. It's always almost Darwin. Our world is so big that you have a big globalization of everything, but also our world is so big that you have individuals popping up everywhere. You can do a product that go in a mainstream global approach, and you can also do a product that is very specialized, and you might find, you know, some people at another scale.
But you have to support yourself, like financially.
So I think that in fashion you don't have only one path. I've seen people well surrounded and not understanding what they could get of their surrounding and use it for building something. And other people that are the first thing that could help them, there is sort of little light that makes it comes to them, and they can use whatever, even a little thing, and it will help and it will go on. But of course it's never easy to start, and sometimes you have to be brave and go through, you know, and you've got to go through.